This bill would create a lot of changes for police departments here in Connecticut, and not all the legislators who worked on it say that they are in agreement with it. But they do all agree that they need the input from the public before this bill goes any further.
Although we may not always agree on every single issue, it is open and transparent dialogue between us that brings us to the product we were able to release last night.
The Police Accountability Draft Bill is a 65-page document put forward by the Judiciary Committee leadership. The document lays out dozens of proposed changes for police departments in Connecticut. One of the biggest changes would be the creation of a new inspector general.
We're going to create an independent office of the inspector general. The Office of the Inspector General will, for administrative purposes only, be housed under the Division of Criminal Justice, but they will have the power and the authority to investigate police use of force cases and to prosecute those cases where necessary.
Among many more changes, some of the highlights include requiring and monitoring police departments to hire a diverse police force, also requiring officers to go through periodic mental health screenings. It would also require both dash and body cameras for all officers and add the creation of civilian review boards for any community that wants one. They would also ban chokeholds. The only time it would be permitted is if an officer's life was in imminent danger. And it would add the ability to decertify an officer.
Post has the ability to remove or decertify a police officer when they've engaged in instances of excess use of force or when they've engaged in conduct that undermines public confidence in law enforcement.
Senator John Kistler, who worked on this bill, says he does not yet fully support it.
I have not personally endorsed this proposal. I'm still looking to hear from my constituents, folks in law enforcement, folks in other communities, and get as much human feedback as possible on this very long and very complex bill.
In a statement sent to Fox 61 from Andrew Matthews, the executive director of the State Police Union, he said, quote, if the proposed bill was to pass in its current form, we believe it would lead many officers in the state of Connecticut to retire, resign, or reconsider police work. Governor Lamont also releasing a statement on this draft bill. He said, quote, the time is now for meaningful police accountability reforms. I wrote to all four caucus leaders in the General Assembly in early June, calling on them to address this important issue. I am pleased to see that they are taking that charge seriously. I look forward to reviewing the bill and working with them to ensure meaningful reforms are implemented. The draft bill will now move on to a public hearing. To read the bill in its entirety, head to our website, fox61.com. From the state capitol, Ashley Afonso, Fox 61 News.